this is one of the changes that a lot of users are being confused by. Speaker identification doesn't work the same way like before. So let me just explain. I'm going to bring this project. It's a single file with two speakers. And Descript actually asks me to identify the speakers. However, if you bring a file directly into Descript and transcribe it, Descript doesn't actually ask you for that anymore. It doesn't ask you to identify speakers. But you see here, I brought this file and I transcribed it. And then if I click in here, I don't have the speakers on this file, but I do have the option to detect speakers. So that's one way to detect speakers. You can do it if you see that pop up, which you don't always see it. And finally, if you go to the project area, you can trigger the speaker identification from there. So I can right click on the file itself and I have the option to identify speakers. This is called identify speakers here. If I click on the speaker name here, it's called detect speakers. And detecting speakers, here we go. And it's now asking you how many. Well, one of the updates, part of the Underlord, was the fact that they no longer need to ask you how many speakers are there because it detects automatically and labels them speaker one, speaker two, speaker three, and then you go and rename them. But if you trigger that manually, if I say right-click in here on the file and say identify speakers, it says, this is different here, right? It says the speaker detective has found multiple speakers in this file. It doesn't ask you how many anymore. Let's see, get started.
You're doing that.
Yeah, I know. Why isn't it this loading? So here I'm typing my name, or I can select my name from the list because I have a speaker.
I want...
And this is my guest. So I type the name and then I select it from the list. There you go. So this is correct. Descript has correctly identified there's two people on that file, and I have now identified and specified who they are. But last week, when Underlord launched, if you're struggling with this, you would see here the detected speakers, and then you could say, click on the name, click on the three dots, rename them if you want to, right? So I can rename them, press enter, and there you go. I renamed them. Instead of speaker one, two, three, you change the name to the actual person. So this is a change. And by the way, if you notice that the speaker identification doesn't work, I've seen situations in the last week where detecting the speaker didn't actually work. It said it did. It said it found two or whatever, but then in the text, it was just one. It was never labeling the speakers. It was never detecting and separating them. If you still see that, I've seen it on two occasions only, then I suppose send a ticket to Descript because they might want to look into it. If it could be a bug. So there you go about the speaker identification now.